I don't want to run away. What would I want to stay strong away from all of my people for? I just like to be secure. I'm trying to see some more food on my mother's plate, food on my brother's plate. Funny how I came out the blue from my blood estate. Now I don't want to run away, but some brothers, they want to gun me down and strip me for my figures. And that's the thanks I get for being strictly for my niggas. That's the thanks I get. They want George money like as the banks to check. The mortality rises as the shanks connect, and everyone copies London as the Manx reflect. Now these are the guys that I sit down in meetings and defend, while their baby mothers live down the beatings and pretend. Yo, it's myself, George the Poet. I'm a 20-year-old spoken word artist from Northwest London, and this is my artist profile. I started doing spoken word because when I used to rap, I felt like people weren't really listening to the lyrics and the substance of what I was saying. And to me, the substance was the most important bit. So for live performances, I took the instrumentals out of the equation and it came across as spoken word. And I preferred that a lot more, so I ran with it. You had to make it through the drugs and the violence. Ignore sounds of the mugs and the miners when they kick doors down for the thugs and the silence. Bare slugs and the tridents with the clubs and the sirens, and half your extended family wants some asylum. You try to get a job and the riots prevent you, plus the education system's biased against you. Dealers on the block are still trying to tempt you, but if hearing that makes the heart in you sink, then clearly you ain't as smart as you think. I think my emphasis is on lyricism more than most. Because I come from a rap background, it matters to me that I have compound rhymes and more wordplay than a lot of other poets have. I feel like my subject matter or some of the sentiments that I express aren't what you typically expect of a performance poet. My earliest inspiration was all of the rappers that I grew up on, so Tupac, Nas, Jay-Z, and then later on when I started listening to Grime, I got into Getz, Wiley, Skepta, and those were the main three influences on me when I was younger. And what them man there showed me was how to put rhymes together. Then from there, I came up with my own messages and things that I wanted to talk about, which came from my environment. In 5 years' time, I see myself as the head of a new movement. And that's not because I want a particular status or because I study at Cambridge. It's because what I'm trying to push for now should come into effect by 5 years' time. And I'm trying to get people to rethink the way they currently think. Like, challenge the assumptions that you carry and challenge everything around you, more or less. If you really believe you can't really achieve much more than hood-level music or basketball, then I guess you ain't a true soldier after all. Don't chat to me if you don't actually think you and I can change the world, because then you don't rate me. But more importantly, I'm not talking to a guy who rates himself. If you're the kind of person that can be told you can't do something you want to do and then accept that, you probably don't deserve whatever you claim you want because you don't want it enough. Take a step back. Stay there with your gun. Don't take care of your son. If you believe the lies they're selling off about you, then little man's probably better off without you. He needs a strong foundation in his life, but you're so soft you doubt you. I don't doubt me, you're mad. Fuck it, I'll be the dad. Sit the boy down and play him my poetry. I guarantee that's gonna sow a seed and grow a tree. But whatever you do, I beg you stop telling him that the world is against him because he's got melanin. That's how social growth stunts interlink, and that's what someone somewhere wants him to think.